The many cases of sexual harassment that female idols had to go through have always been a much criticized aspect of the K-pop industry. But such cases often don't receive as much attention when the victims are of the opposite gender. In today's video, we'll talk about 7 sexual harassment incidents concerning male idols and the inappropriate behaviors they were subjected to. Number 1. EXO's Kai. Earlier this March, comedian Park Na-rae was receiving huge backlash from netizens for the crude remarks that she made in her YouTube show, Hey Na-rae. Among them is a joke she made in reference to what Kai once said in the variety show Knowing Brothers, in which the idol misheard his teammate's words, thought that he had to guess a 2-letter word for something inside his underpants, and looked down in confusion. The event must have made such a strong impression on Na-rae that she still remembered it after 3 years had passed. Taking full advantage of the show's 15 and up rating, Na-rae gave a nonchalant answer to what the 2-letter word for something inside Kai's pants was, a gochu, aka pepper or the male genital. Kai's situation in Knowing Brothers was a genuine mishearing, but there wasn't anything unintentional about Na-rae referring to another person's private part like that. Her show was eventually canceled with all of its content deleted, for all the inappropriate comments and behaviors she'd sprinkled throughout. But her remark towards Kai had later prompted police investigation for alleged sexual harassment. Sadly, this wasn't the first time that Kai was a victim of harassment. In 2013, Sasaeng fans were reportedly touching Kai in inappropriate places in addition to pushing him and badly injuring his legs when EXO was at the Incheon airport departing for an overseas schedule. From obsessive fans to a renowned public figure, Kai just can't seem to catch a break when all he did was breathe and be himself. Number 2. Zico. In 2016, on the topic of idol group members with tattoos, the cast of the talk show Video Star were specifically discussing Zico's, as his brother, Taewoon, was invited as a guest. Taewoon explained that Zico's tattoo of their mother on his left chest was the idol's way of keeping her close to his heart and emphasizing her importance in his life. The heartwarming feeling Taewoon evoked didn't last long when entertainer Kim Soo cut in with an unexpected comment. In her opinion, as meaningful as the tattoo was, it would be awkward for whoever married Zico in the future, since the girl's mother-in-law would be staring at her the entire time they were doing it all night. Taewoon salvaged the situation by saying that Zico probably didn't think that far, and the conversation ended shortly after. But netizens were gravely disappointed by the inappropriate comment made by Kim Soo. A discourse on the remark was taken onto Instas, with some fans regarding the situation as harassment towards Zico. No matter what anyone says, it's best to leave things like this for Zico's future lover to figure out. Number 3. B1A4 and Infinite. Both B1A4 and Infinite were the victims of several SNL Korea's production team members' improper acts. The incident first came to light when a video of the show's female staff rushing towards B1A4 and touching the members circulated around the internet. Among them was the popular comedian and actress Lee Se-young, who received the most criticism for not acting in accordance with her status as a celebrity, as well as a crew member. Two of the B1A4 members looked absolutely stunned, and even covered their private parts with their hands afterwards, which makes it irrefutable that the boys had been touched without consent. As if that wasn't disgusting enough, netizens soon discovered that this wasn't the first time that the SNL Korea staff had sexually harassed their guests. The same thing had happened to Infinite a month prior to the B1A4 incident, with Lee Se-young being the center of attention again. In the video that netizens found, while all the other female crew members had stopped their inappropriate touching, Se-young could be seen reaching for the Infinite members' crotch area before she walked away with a celebratory fist pump. Severe internet backlash had prompted both SNL Korea and Lee Se-young herself to make a public apology. Se-young was also subjected to police investigation, but the charges against her were cleared as both the members of B1A4 and Infinite stated that she did not physically touch them. Regardless of whether physical contact happened or not, it was clear that the SNL Korea staff made both groups extremely uncomfortable with a sexual-based joke that went too far, and that Lee Se-young completely deserves to be pressed charged against. Number 4. VIX's In. 6 years ago, in the variety show Shin Dong-yup's Bachelor Party, a discussion of things the cast members wish women wouldn't do when they're drinking in a group brought in a chance to talk about his unsettling experience. He started the conversation by saying how some women kept touching men here and there, as though all men liked it if the woman initiated skinship. Then confessed that during a company dinner, he felt extremely uncomfortable when a female staff member kept rubbing his thighs. You'd think that N would be taken seriously when he was brave enough to openly discuss harassment, but sadly, that wasn't the case. One of the cast members replied, "Really? I like it when women touch me first." Then proceeded to reenact the scene with another member sitting next to him. What happened to N was also neither covered widely in news articles, nor talked about among K-pop fans. So we can only hope that the female staff in question had since been fired and that N's personal boundaries are more respected. Number 5. 2PM's Taekyeon. Imagine scrolling through social media to see that people are talking suggestively about you. Yup, that's what happened to Taekyeon when he just wanted to keep up with his fans. Two Twitter users were publicly talking about different idols in a highly sexualized manner, and Taekyeon was unfortunately caught up in the mess. The fans made references to his and even talked about how he probably had an erection sickness, letting their imaginations run wild. Taekyeon was understandably furious as he replied to the two perverted users that he'd take legal actions and make an example out of them. The idol further posted the status, "Patience, patience. I don't have any more patience. Don't wish for any mercy from me. I won't give it," on his account. Number 6. 18. 18 was a group of 10 trainees who were promoting in Japan prior to their scheduled Korean debut, with two of their members having participated in Produce 101 Season 2. While the boys worked towards their dreams, none of them would have imagined the horror that they would be subjected to by the president of their own label, DS&A Entertainment. In 2019, six 18 members had filed a lawsuit at the Seoul Central Police District against their female CEO and the wife of a chairman for sexually assaulting them at a sushi restaurant in Tokyo, Japan. Translations of their testimonies were posted on various social media websites, such as Twitter and Instagram. The abuse left such a deep mental scar on the members that some even had to seek psychiatric treatment. 18 also posted a picture on Instagram with the caption, "We hope that justice will be implemented. Please help us," and changed their bio to, "We'll be back," which prompted netizens to take actions by trending hashtags and bringing awareness to the issue. The outcome of their lawsuit remains unknown even until now, but we hope that the perpetrators are justly punished. Number 7. G-Dragon. G-Dragon must be one of the most unlucky male idols on this list, as his personal space has been inappropriately invaded not just once, but at least 3 times. Firstly, when Big Bang came back to Korea after finishing their world tour in China, a female fan was caught following G-Dragon. She nonchalantly touched G-Dragon from behind, but the idol kept his ice-cold composure and kept on walking, as if he didn't even want to acknowledge the crazy fan's existence. Half a year later, in a Big Bang fan meeting in Hong Kong, G-Dragon thought that a female fan wanted to whisper something to him, but as he leaned down, she took the chance to kiss him on the cheek. G-Dragon was clearly taken aback and had to take a full minute to process what happened. He was polite to the girl and even said that he was happy, but I don't think that was a good move considering G-Dragon's status as a celebrity, his other fans, and a clear lack of permission. Last but not least, while G-Dragon was performing at his solo concert in 2017, a supposedly drunk audience member carrying the Big Bang lightstick suddenly appeared on stage. She grabbed G-Dragon's jacket, flung her arm around his neck, then pulled him towards her, before a security guard intervened and brought her off the stage. Though the three girls from the three incidents were all heavily criticized by netizens for their behaviors, it seems few people considered this as sexual harassment. So, which incident from today's video stood out to you? And what's your opinion on the sexual harassment of male idols? Comment down below to share your thoughts with us. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to BBoss TV for more interesting content. Thank you for watching.